What's going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're gonna break down Microsoft To Do and show you guys how it actually can be a nice tool in your tool belt when trying to increase your productivity. Before we get into the topic of this video, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so that you can stay up to date with all of my latest videos. With that being said, let's dive right in to Microsoft To Do.
So let's dive right into Microsoft To Do. I'm really excited for this one. This is actually the productivity app that I use at work. And I don't know, I actually like it a fair amount. After using Notion for so long, it has been nice to broaden my horizons and try other things out. So a brief overview. I mean, Microsoft To Do is a very basic sort of, here is a task, you know, and it gives you these options after you make one. You can add notes. There's the option for recurring tasks. You can add due dates, reminders that have times associated with them. It's very simple stuff. There are a lot of different parts of it that I'd like to point out to you guys, but overall, it's something that you can kind of mess around with and just quickly make tasks. You know, there's a task due tomorrow. Here is a record B-roll footage for today. And this kind of stuff, very simple. If I wanted to remind myself of the fact that it needs to be done at 5:30 this morning, I'm already during B-roll recording, but it was supposed to start at 5:30 and it did. Go here. All right, that's really nice. It's a nice start to stuff. I think that we can go in and also just look at and break down the other parts of it that are good. So the recurring tasks aspect of it, I think is important. It's a very basic to-do list that can have multiple steps to it, which is nice, but having recurring tasks with these multiple steps. So I could say something along the lines of set up lighting, set up mic, set up chair, honestly. And then after that, we can make it recur weekly. And since it's due today on a Thursday, what we actually can do is something that I really like. We have recurring tasks and that's great. We can make it custom. It could repeat every day, every week, every month, every year. Or we can make it repeat every 2 weeks. We could on a specific day. This custom function for recurring is actually really nice. You can make it be on multiple different days of the week. It's got nice recurring tasks functionality. And the nice thing is, say for example, here is an example list of notes. Here is another thing. Or if I'd attach a file to it, or if I added more steps to it. So let's go and say, record footage, transfer files to project folders. Okay, so that's nice. But if I do all these things and then go bada boom, that's completed, right? And it'll actually just create the new event with all of these subtasks and the list of notes, as well as if we had a file, it attach it to it. So that's really nice. I think recurring tasks are very basic in here. They do keep the previous information moving forward, which can be good or bad, but it does reset the list of tasks, which I really like. Actually, what I think would be nice is if next we went into the different lists that you can make, which are really helpful. So move this task to Tuesday. So I at work actually have something that's like weekly recurring tasks with a bunch of templates for stuff. And as you can see here, there is a bunch of different lists. So you can create lists in Microsoft To Do, but you can also create list groups, which is what I ended up doing. And I made a bunch of sublists within weekly recurring tasks. So as you can see, I then have these lists with example recurring tasks on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So if we go to Thursday, actually, I moved this to the wrong one. So if we move this to Thursday, you can see that there's a nice way to kind of get a checklist of things each week that you always do. But there is also a really nice way to actually get your day planned out and have that daily planner view pretty easily. So if you go to my day, so at the beginning of work, basically what will happen is a lot of my recurring tasks will populate and stuff that I've written down will populate. And all I have to do here is right click go to add to my day. And then after that, you can kind of go through as well and see on the planned page if there's anything else. So let's see what else is due today. Right click this. It's already on my day. Then we go to right click this, control T, right click this, control T, and it'll show you what's completed for the day once you complete it. So a bi-weekly example right here, I can press this and it'll show what's completed and move whatever else is to the top. So I'm going to uncheck these and also show you guys the functionality regarding how you can organize these different things. So you can sort by either importance, due date, alphabetically, or creation date. What I think is good is sorting by importance, right? So if I mark something like this for record B-roll, this is the most important thing for me in the morning or at work. You know, there are things that have priority levels. And basically, since it's my own personal task management system, I just have to kind of communicate with the powers that be, you know, what is more important than the other. And then I kind of just mark these and then I tackle the starred ones first. And then after that, we can tackle the ones that aren't starred. And then if something new comes up, that's more important. If you press the star, it'll mark it as important and it'll take precedence over the previously marked as important task. So at work as well, what's nice is at the moment we have some planner tasks that go on and this actually can sync and be assigned to me. So this would show if I was assigned something from somebody else, you can actually assign people tasks in Microsoft To Do via Microsoft Planner. Or so if we wanted to assign tasks to other people, we could make like a delegate list, a delegation list or something. And then actually it's nice you can customize this and mark it as whatever. Not really sure what the symbol should be, so let's just go with that. We can do example task to assign, do tomorrow, right click, do tomorrow. And then we can assign this to somebody. So you can create an invitation link to have someone join your sort of group on Microsoft To Do, and that'd be great. It's really nice with like Outlook and the whole Microsoft suite. I think they've gotten better with improving things over time in Microsoft. So we can see that this is a decently collaborative option. A nice thing that would be showing up if I had a proper Outlook account connected to this would be this. You can actually connect your Outlook to have it so that flagged emails show up. So in any sort of email on Outlook, if you were to right click it and flag it, it would take in all the information as shown here. Sorry for not having it shown properly, but I can't use my work one and I'm not going to use my old school one because that's getting discontinued. So the moment I don't have any sort of, you know, Outlook based email. So this example kind of fell short. So diving really quick into the aesthetics and personalization that can be used within Microsoft To Do, you can change the theme here. You can make it just color based if you want. There's not a whole lot of options, I will be honest. It's kind of limited. However, you know, I think as a minimalist, I don't really care that much. Like mine at work is just set up to have like red as the color or something. I don't really mind. But overall, it's pretty nice that you can make lists that have these different emojis. You can separate these lists into things like groceries. And here are some example getting started ones that they give you. I think overall, this is a pretty good software. The aesthetics part of it, very, very small, like not very large in general. I think it's nice that there's these different functionalities, especially with work and the flagged email thing.
With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.